How are you doing? Tell me below. Because I'm doing like well, but also questionable. So if you're new here, I'm Maddie Mae. Welcome back to my channel. I'm really excited you're here and I'm excited for 2021 because I'm gonna be making some bomb videos in 2021. But the last month, like January, the end of December, beginning of January, I have not posted. And at first that was like my intentional break because I was spending the time with my boyfriend. I was reflecting on the new year, making a vision board, purchasing a new planner that we'll talk about, and just kind of like gearing up for the new year. And I was gonna like really start vlogging maybe the third day of January and just get up a really cool like New Year's vlog, I guess. But my parents got two puppies. And when my sister moved to Tennessee, our family dog Harley went with her, and the whole family just missed having a dog around. And so for Christmas this year, they got two German Shepherd puppies, and they did not come from a puppy mill. It was very organic, and so I'm proud of my parents for pursuing that route. But anyways, we got two new puppies, and so we brought them home on December 31st, and at that point I was still with Barrett in Minnesota. And so when I came back, my parents had been with the dogs for a few days and they were just exhausted because puppy life is a lot. They keep you up pretty much all night because they get up three times during the night, and you have to kind of keep them on a schedule. You basically have to be a really good puppy owner in order to have a really enjoyable adult dog. So we've been very intentional about raising these puppies the right way so everything turns out great in the future. And so when I got back from Minnesota, my parents were just exhausted. My little brother and sister were exhausted. Everyone was just doing everything in their will to not go crazy because they hadn't slept. So when I got back from Minnesota, I was like, I'll take over. I took over a few nights and have just been watching them during the day while Henry and Lola are at school and my parents are at work. So I basically just didn't get to vlog because I've just been so exhausted. Right now they're napping next to me, and so that's why I'm talking to you guys, but it's been rough. So there's a little update and reasoning why I kind of ghosted you guys for the end and beginning of the year. But I'm going back to school in a week, so after I get back to Knoxville, I have new classes. I have so many new items that I'm just really excited about incorporating into my life. I got so many candles for Christmas. I got some face masks. I got a new planner for the new year. There's just so many things I'm excited to incorporate into my life when I get back to school. And so yeah, the vlogs will get more consistent and stuff once I get back to school, but right now I'm just trying to help my parents get through this puppy stage. They're honestly really, really good dogs. Like, they're not bad at all. It's just that it's so cold outside. So whenever you take them to pee, which is like about every hour, it's just freezing to go outside. So that's kind of been the worst part, is having to bundle up in clothing every time they have to go to the bathroom, which is every hour. So, and then nighttime's been hard, but otherwise they're really good about napping and playtime, and so it's been really good. I'm just a tired girl. So there's my update, and I do have quite a few little mini clips that I wanted to include in this video because on December 18th it was my birthday, and I just have some random funny vlog footage from my birthday, so I wanted to include that in here. I'll include those and any other vlog footage that you have, that I have. When you guys get back, it will be Tuesday, which is tomorrow. My parents actually hired a woman to come watch the puppies on Tuesday and Thursday this week. So both of those days, I'm just gonna get so much done. I'm gonna go to a workout class. I'm going to clean my room that's an absolute mess. I want to show you guys my new planner and how I'm planning on using it. So Tuesday is going to be like a very productive work day, and I also have a dentist appointment tomorrow at 5 p.m. So I will see you guys after these like birthday dog clips, and we can get started with a really productive vlog.
Okay, Maddie, we have a new question for you.
Okay.
All right, since it's almost your birthday.
What?
Change the date on the calendar. Okay, we will.
You just ruined it. I have to redo it now.
Wow, I didn't even take it.
Okay, Maddie, so. So, because it's almost your birthday, I have a question for you.
Okay. Make it quick, I might have to get to my appointment.
Okay. What is your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to get my health in check. I also want to get into med school.
Okay. Maddie, I know you're running late, but.
Again.
So, since tomorrow you're turning 22, okay. What are you going to be doing on your 22nd birthday? Like, what are the highlights of your day tomorrow?
So, tomorrow I'm going to get my nails done. My grandparents are coming, so I'll get to spend time with them. I'm making those buffalo chicken egg roll wraps, and I'm also going to be spending time with my dog, my sister's dog, and I'm also going to be opening presents.
Okay.
Wait, so I have a question for the paparazzi.
Okay.
Paparazzi, what are you looking forward to for Christmas?
I'm looking forward to opening presents and being with my family and hanging out with friends.
Mom, what's a good paparazzi question?
I have a good one.
Maddie, I know you're on a busy schedule right now, but when you were seen last night with a group of four girls, young girls, what were you doing?
Taking them to school.
At night?
At night?
Night school.
They posted on Instagram that they were going to go talk to boys.
Right, so fine. They want to ding dong ditch someone named Lola's crush.
No, don't post this. Cut the cameras.
Okay, so my favorite cake of all time is coffee cake.
And like, so, do you know any other 8-year-olds that have coffee cakes for their birthday parties? Because Maddie did.
Yeah, that's what I wanted for my birthday cake. I don't know why. It's just like the perfect, it's not too sweet, but it's also the perfect amount of sweet.
We had to,
and
we were out of.
I also love breakfast, and it's the perfect breakfast cake. You know what I'm saying, Mom? Mm-hmm.
I have makeup under my eyes, but I'm 22 today. I actually have a video I need to finish and upload today, so as soon as we have our coffee cake, we're gonna do that. Drink some water. So I need to take my charger and computer downstairs, an iPad for graphics.
What would you think of me now? So lucky, so strong, so.
Okay, guys, my mom said I could open my book. I'm opening. I have like 3 other presents, I think, that we're opening once my grandparents get here and once my parents get home. But my mom said I can open my book because it's this store novel, and so I know that's a bookstore.
I know. It's a bookstore.
Glennon Doyle, that's what I was like, it's either this one or The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. I've been wanting to read this for so long. I was gonna buy the audiobook, but I went against it and bought the Jay Shetty book instead. But now I can read it and highlight in it. That's the other reason I didn't buy the audiobook, because you can't highlight in audiobooks. So, very excited about this. Probably will read it today. Now let's give the coffee cake a try. Looks good. It's good. I'll link it below for you guys.
Guys, I'm so excited. I just got an unexpected package in the mail. I found them on Instagram. I don't even remember how I found them. My gosh, it already smells good. So I guess you guys can half guess what it is. Okay, so this company is from Illuminate Candles. Wait, they smell so good. They smell so good and they're perfect. It smells so good. Look, it's a body, a woman's body, but it's a candle. Oh my goodness. It is beautiful. I love this one. The woman who owns this business is so sweet.
Guys, I will definitely link her company below. The candles are so well priced and they're just absolutely beautiful. Look what happens when the wax drips. Just so beautiful.
Good morning, you guys. I look disgusting, but it's okay.
I just imported some footage. I want to edit this video today, and it's all about narrative medicine.
So if you guys have ever wondered about what the heck my major means, what I plan to do with it, go check that video out because it's probably already up. I'm going to put on a little bit of sunscreen. I've been using the Supergoop Glow Screen. I am obsessed with this stuff. Phenom, truly phenom. This book is insane. And I know I'm really late on the bandwagon because this came out a while ago and I saw people were buying it. I was like, I don't usually like self-help books. This is just different. It's told almost like a memoir, but in like little snippet stories. So it's basically little snippet stories of this woman's life. I'm reading it at a normal pace right now, but then once I finish, I'm gonna go through and highlight the heck out of it because it is just so good. It's called Untamed by Glennon Doyle. All right guys, editing session has begun. I'm drinking a Brew Doctor kombucha, and I really wanna get this video up for you guys today. So editing session begins now.
All right, you guys, it's 12:37. I've been editing forever. This video is 18 minutes and I still have quite a bit to go through, but I'm loving it so far and I can't wait to see it. So go watch my narrative medicine video if you haven't already. Do you guys sometimes think about how cute Harley is? Do you think about it? Harley, do they think about it like I do? Yes, I think they do. They're like, I think Harley is the cutest puppy I've ever seen. Gorgeous, gorgeous girl. Guys, I wrapped this present yesterday. What do you guys think it is? It has a certain shape, but I can't really pinpoint it.
Can I see it? Can I see it, boy? Harley, come on. Come on.
I wanted to ask you guys, what is it that you like to see in my vlogs? Because I was gonna say, what is it you guys like about my vlogs? But I feel like I get the consistent idea of what you guys like about them. But what do you like to see? Because I've been really struggling lately on how much of my talking to include in the video. Because I personally love when YouTubers go off on random tangents and don't edit out a ton of like of them talking. But at the same time, I know sometimes I feel like anxious. So I kind of like skip them talking because I'm just like, okay, get to the point, which sounds rude, but it's like, I know there's two different types of people out there and I kind of seem to be both of them. It just depends on my mood. So I want to know if you guys like chatty vlogs or if you really like the kind of crisply edited versions and stuff. I don't know.
Say hi.
Hi.
What's up?
I got a block. Actually, I got two blocks.
Dopatron.
This is so exciting. Okay, so I don't know. I definitely didn't tell you guys on the YouTube, but I follow this Instagram account called Bitches Who Read, and you guys should follow them. They give such good book reviews, and so I just kind of randomly entered one of their giveaways. I think they were asking, like, what's your favorite book of 2020, and so I was just like, I know my favorite book. It was Educated by Tara Westover, by the way. But I entered the giveaway, and I won five
books. What is that tripod?
Yeah, you guys are on a sanitizing spray bottle. But I won, and I truly cannot believe I won. Harley, now is not the time, girl. I got the what you win is five books from like genres that they pick from, but then they posted on their Instagram, and so I know what books I'm getting, but I haven't really looked super in depth about like what the titles are. So, and they're all like new too. She ordered them new. I wouldn't have necessarily minded if they were used, but it just, like, a new book smell is just perfect. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Yay! Hold on. There's a little letter. So let's read that. It says, "Dear Maddie, congrats on being our giveaway winner. We appreciate your support and that you're a bitch who reads. We hope that these books are new to your collection and that they satisfy all your literary cravings. Can't wait to hear what you think. Happy reading." Okay, we got Before We Were Yours. This is the thriller, I think. The Turn of the Key by Ruth Ware. This is a really good author. My sister, who is the queen of thrillers, told me that Ruth is a really good author. This is one I'm super excited about. It's supposed to be kind of like The Handmaid's Tale. So it's called The Grace Year. And I loved The Handmaid's Tale. The Idea of You. My mom said this one's supposed to be good. And lastly, which I'm so excited about, is Open Book by Jessica Simpson. This is a memoir that I have not read, but everyone has told me I should read. So I'm so excited about all of these. Yay, this just made the vlog so much more fun.
Guys, I just uploaded the video and talked about it on my stories. I always like to tell you guys when I post. I really do think it helps, and it also, like, people always reply to my Instagram stories, and it just kind of is fun to talk to you guys when a new video goes up. There's no one in town, no, no. You gave us some place to go. Never said thank you for that. Thought I might get one more chance. Normally I was going to sleep at 8:22. Am I right? I'll talk to you guys in the morning. Bye. Okay guys, so you caught me on an ad. I was just watching some Vlogmas, and Harley's in here with the door closed because my dad is mopping right now, and so they just wanted Harley in my room. I think I'm gonna read for a little bit. This book is just too good. Right now we're talking about like racial injustices and stuff, but there was a chapter previously. I need to save my, I'll just remember 211. That's what page I was on. The one part, okay, Keys, part two, Keys was like probably my favorite section. This section was like, I'm gonna return to part two for the rest of my life. I'm never getting rid of this book. And Aches was really good. Mirrors. There's just so many good nuggets of wisdom in here. Oh, I think the one about boys was Poems and Boys. This whole little section just reminded me of my brother so much, and just so good. Okay, but anyways, I'm gonna keep reading 211.
Merry Christmas. Are you guys, good morning, it is Christmas. It's like 7:55, I think. I'm probably not gonna vlog too much this morning, but I'll get some b-roll for you guys. I'm just feeling happy.
Good morning.
Watch us.
Are you eating a greenie? So cute. Look at the tree. So pretty. Just like you, Lola. And the fire is so delightful. Coffee first. Amazing, Dad. Don't burn yourself.
Hi, guys.
And so, what's your favorite thing you got?
Orange Theory membership. If you guys don't know, this is like a workout membership, and I'm just excited to have some workout structure in my life, you know what I'm saying?
Coming close in second, I would say, is probably your Doc Martens.
Yeah, I got the vegan Doc Martens. I sent these to my grandma a while ago, and I didn't know if she would.
Alright guys, so later today we're going to watch the new Disney movie. It's on Disney Plus, and it's called Soul. I feel like it's going to give me the vibes that Inside Out gave me, and also,
we have one more present, and it's two puppies.
Disney Plus.
Are you serious? Can't even believe it. I can't either.
Hey guys, so Maddie's upstairs. She's probably asleep. But I just wanted to put this clip in and say that we love you, Maddie. You're the best.
And Merry Christmas 2020.
Merry Christmas. Sometimes you're kind of mean to me, but it's fine about my hair. But yeah, still love you. Merry Christmas.
Now make sure.
How do I turn it off? Is it? So I just woke up and the dog sitter is going to be here in a few minutes. I'm going to a workout class where masks are required the whole time. I'm still waking up right now, so I'm not really going to talk. But I'm just going to put on a little bit of glow screen sunscreen for the workout class. Nothing special, but it has sunscreen. Sorry for the god-awful lighting, but I swear this glow screen does wonders. Even if it doesn't look like it right now, I promise it does wonders.
All right guys, I got this.
This is my first Lululemon thing. It's the Align tank because I had seen so many people talking about it. And I just have to say, worth the hype. Like 1000% worth the hype. I'm definitely buying more of these tops. They're so fun to work out in because they're just so comfy. And they just hug my body perfectly. I'm 5'11", 6 foot, and I have some boobies. So I am a size 10. So if you guys want to use that little reference. But I'm obsessed with it. It's just so cute. I love it. All right, you guys, I just got out of my class. It was phenom. We have to wear a mask the whole time. I just took it off. I am obsessed with Orange Theory. Like that's the workout class I was going to. I'm like dead right now, so that's why I can't really talk. But I just love Orange Theory, and it was my main Christmas present this year. That's what I asked for, was an Orange Theory membership for 6 months. So I'm just trying to get everything I can out of the 6 months. And let me tell you, it is just the best like physical health decision I've made in a really long time. And I just always I leave feeling so good. And so if you have a birthday coming up or some sort of gift giving thing, I know Christmas just passed, but I feel like that is a great gift to ask from your parents or grandparents. And it's something that you could really, really benefit from. So anyways, you actually get a heart monitor. I need to turn mine off, so I'm glad I pulled it out because I always forget to turn it off. But you get a heart monitor and it tracks everything throughout the workout, so you can kind of see it on the screen, and it also saves all of them on your phone, all the stats. So I love to look back and see how I did. But I'm hoping everything's going good for the pet sitter right now. We're gonna go back and see her and the puppies, and I will see you guys then, and we can continue with our productive day.
All right, the first thing we're gonna do is tame these clothes. So this is from my Minnesota trip. This is just the clothes I brought for the winter. I've been here since November, so that's why I brought basically my whole wardrobe. This closet is currently being used as storage, so I haven't been able to put away my clothes in 2 months, and it sucks, but I just want to contain it. And I'm about to take that stuff downstairs to do some laundry while I eat lunch, and then we will tame the rest of this mess. I'm going to listen to a podcast. Alright, I know this still looks like a lot, because it is, but I just have an open floor now, and it's amazing. But I'm going to use this little tub that I was using for clothing and put all of my like Christmas presents that I'm taking back with me to Knoxville. I have all of these books. By the way, this one is the one I'm reading right now, The Gracier, and it is so good. I'm really hoping to finish it before I go back to school. Literally, it's like a mix between Handmaid's Tale and The Hunger Games. It is just so good. So this is the one I'm reading right now, but these are all on the loading dock. So I have a bunch of books. I have this amazing vase I'm so excited about. It's like a booty vase, and I'm obsessed with it. I have these candles that you guys have seen. Literally, this whole thing needs to be cleared off. I have my shampoo and conditioner. I just want to put all of my gifts and stuff in this little tub. I have these things for my mom. Just a lot of little things, so I'm glad I have this.
Of a woman, although now most of my days are spent alone, a thousand miles from the place I was born.
Everything is clean. I need to wipe this off, but it's so clean. All the clothes are put away, the shoes. This is nice and clean. I just feel so good.
But now that this is clean, I am going to go get some. I'm gonna go get some last minute ingredients for a vegan pad thai that I'm making tonight. Can't decide if I wanna put on some makeup. I might put on a little bit.
Now most days I spend
like so excited about this one. I love Olipop.
The sun came out. And I just like had simply forgotten about it. I feel like it's been cloudy in Indiana forever, and I just like wasn't even paying attention to the fact it was cloudy until I just walked the dogs outside and was just overwhelmed with sunshine. It's great. The dogs are in their pen right now. They are chilling, not really. It's gonna be for 5 seconds and then they start playing again, just like that. But I'm taking some time and responding to DMs. I always like to reply to my DMs from you guys. I'm taking this little 10 minutes to reply to some DMs while the dogs are playing. Oh, you're so sweet. Okay, yes. Also gonna get on the trend of drinking kombucha out of a wine glass, because it's actually one of my goals in 2021 to like elevate my life in cheap ways, you know, like in easy ways, just live a more elevated lifestyle. And so this is one of the ways you can do that. Like, why the heck not? I don't know, I feel like that would be a fun video idea of like ways to amplify and elevate your everyday life that is like affordable. So let me know if you guys would like that video, because I think that would be really fun to brainstorm.
Are you strong enough to be my man?
All right guys, I just passed off Ozzy to my mom, but I'm about to do some skincare. I had to leave my face wash in Minnesota with Barrett because it was over like 3 or whatever ounces, so he's gonna mail it to me. So I've been using the natural facial cleansing pads from Trader Joe's. They're just tea tree things, but usually I like to use my cleanser. And then I like to put on the Summer Fridays mask, usually like 3 times a week. And then on the nights I don't use the Summer Fridays mask, I just use the CeraVe daily moisturizing lotion. So I really want to read my book. I am not kidding when I tell you guys this book is so good. You have to read it. Kind of like the first 2 chapters are a little slow. I feel like every book has really slow first couple chapters because you have to get to know the characters, but once you get the characters down and the story actually begins, it's just like so good. I haven't read like a fiction book this good in a while. So it's, again, it's called The Grace Here.
Are you strong enough to be mine?